stressful for the swatting calls to North Dakota schools has been tough. This is when someone makes a fake emergency call with the intention of dispatching a large police response to a specific location. Valley News Team's Nishe Taylor dug into what can be done to catch these callers and explains the challenges law enforcement officers are facing.
We're going to stand by for now. It might be a swatting call.
Multiple schools across the state, including Fargo, West Fargo, and Jamestown, were on high alert last week after fake threats were made as part of a trend called swatting. The act can lead to a heightened police response that not only puts pressure on law enforcement, but also causes tension for others involved.
Very stressful for students, for school administration. So it's a very concerning event when it happens.
But how can these calls be combated? Deputy Chief Brett Johnson from the Grand Forks Police Department says that can be very difficult to do. He says in most cases, these calls are made from internet phone numbers.
The great majority of the time, if not every time, if we are able to capture a phone number where the call came in from, it comes back to a number that's essentially untraceable.
Johnson also says the caller can come in different forms, such as a real person or an automated voice. He says this is one of the key details that school districts should remember to take note of in these kinds of events.
You know, if it's a computer generated voice, that's something we'd want to know. If they're saying things that don't really make sense for your particular facility, that's something that we would want to know.
Johnson also added whether the call is believed to be fake, they always take it seriously.
To treat each one like it's the real thing, and you don't want to let your guard down and you make those kind of assumptions.
In Grand Forks, Nishe Taylor, Valley News Live.
Barnesville High was also involved in the swatting calls. A high school student was arrested and released back to his parents after officers found that student had no means to carry out the threat.